Hey everybody, what is going on? It's Brian with you from the GameCom, and we're playing some more Total War Warhammer. We are continuing with the Dwarf campaign. What the heck happened here? Who is this? Top Knots. Alright, well, that sounds good. So we're currently besieging, finally, Doc Caras again, and I'm pretty sure starting next turn, yeah, they're going to start taking damage, which means we're getting pretty close to actually being able to take this entire province. You are trying to move back home. It looks like we ended up spending all of our money, so it's pretty much time for next turn, unless you can do something, but you can't, because we need to assassinate with you. And then we ended up taking Kazad Kurliz. We ended up taking over that. And we're basically waiting to see what happens here, whether Kislev, the bear people, what they end up doing. Hopefully they just destroy it and we can just, you know, spend some gold to resettle it. That's kind of what I'm hoping is going to happen. This is really pretty, by the way. All the water up on the rocks. I really, really like this game. This game's really pretty. It's really fun. So anyways, we're trying to move you closer. We can't get you closer. We only have one grudge left, and that grudge is to get our engineer to 10. Yeah, our master engineer to level 10, and he's like level 1 right now, so yeah. Speaking of that, I think he just leveled up. This is Ingram Ironfist. He was the main leader of that army. I think we're actually going to go for purebred down here. So we're going to do Route Marcher first. And then I'm pretty sure, yeah, this is our master engineer. So he is now level 2. Yippee, yippee. Once again, I think we're going to go for here. Additional construction costs. So that's negative 20% now if he does that. That's nice. Although reload time reduction is amazing. Triangulation. Missile damage. Oh my gosh. Nah, man. Nah. We got to go up here. This is pretty ridiculously good. For missiles and everything like that. So even though I don't foresee him being in any combat anytime soon, probably want to roll this way. So we need 8 more levels with him. May want to send him just to, like, do some attacking and stuff like that, and hopefully maybe, perhaps get some XP that way, killing some enemies. Now, the question is, are we going to go siege that other town that's down there? Maybe? Oh, did they break out? What happened there? So, he took his army, and he's moving his army towards him. All right. They're just raiding now, so they're not even sieging it down. Okay, well, I guess that's our cue to go attack them. We are level 2, so I guess let's go ahead and move you up here. Now, the downside with this, of course, is we're going to be losing a lot of public order. So let's go ahead and turn it off. And we're only going to lose negative 2, which won't be so bad. The next episode, or at least next turn, we're going to be able to start sieging that down. Down here, I could go start sieging, but I think instead I would rather get you out and get you healed up. But the big thing is, like, let's put you in a spot where you're not going to take attrition. So you're going to be getting a little bit of HP that way. That's fine. Now, let's see how much damage we did. We did an okay amount. Drag them. They got 3 turns left. I think we may just hold out for those 3 turns. I'm not really doing anything right now that I actually need units for. And then we have you here now. So let's go ahead and get you off march. And let's get you over here. Sounds good. And we have a little bit of money now. So we could go probably build a lot of things. Let's see. All right. So we got Karagdon. That one's back there. That one's pretty safe. We don't need a gate over there. We have Iron Rock, which is currently level 3. Are we going to do the arsenal? I think we are going to do the arsenal. And there's also 20% cheaper reduction for melee units. So let's go ahead and get ourselves a melee sparring chamber here. And then let's go ahead and look for an arsenal next turn, because we can't afford it this turn. income generated, that's only going to give me 50. You are just doing public order, which isn't that big of a deal. Can you give me more money? You can give me more growth. You can go from 300 to 400, an extra 100 gold. We also now have you rank 3. So I probably need to do military there, but I think I'm looking for gold right now. We could also come here and get a trading depot or a hunting lodge. I think for now, let's just upgrade you. We still have 1,000 left. The Kara Hills. Probably, let's just do a hunting lodge. I think that's going to be fine for now. We do not have enough surplus to actually level you up, because... No, actually we do. So is that better then? Level up Karakurdan? Versus all the things I'm doing here? That's an extra 100 gold. I think we are going to unclick you. Let's go ahead and level up this one. Wait, why can't I? 1600. We have a surplus. Oh, because we don't have 1600. We're making 3,700. Screw it. Let's do it. We'll have enough next turn. Come on, game. That one. That one. Thank you. All right. Nothing else we wanted to do right now, correct? We should probably go ahead and move you back home. We already moved you. And we already did your thing. So, yeah. We're done. Next turn. Probably going to peace out the greenskins as soon as I take over this province. I don't see... But then again, I kind of need someone to war against. And I don't know who we're going to war against. Oh, they wrecked it. Okay. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So they ended up destroying that province. Sweet. So I appreciate that very much. Let's go ahead and resettle, please, if we can go into regular.
Ready axes.
And it's going to be 1,000 gold, so let's colonize with an S. That's weird. So province, North World's Edge Mountains. We obtained complete control of the province, and we can now do a commandment. Nice. So, clearly, well, we're at plus 11 right now. What is their chaos? Their rate's pretty good. So I'm thinking let's do growth, actually. Growth is going to level it up so we can actually... Well, it's going to give us more population surplus so I can level these up. I think that might be a little more advantageous right now than anything else we could do. So we now have the mountains pretty well ours. I know about Texas. Can I actually go up over here? I think this is all, like, empty. Oh, snap. So Volkskrad is now ruins, which means that the chaos actually took it over, because I'm pretty sure that was Kislev's territory to begin with. And Kislev's actually pretty weak in this game. In my game on the humans, like, essentially Kislev's about the only one I haven't taken over yet. And they have like 12 provinces or something, or settlements. They're at 4, so not bad. Whose strength rate is chaos are 2 and 5. We're number 1 right now. Border princes are 6. Beastmen are 10. So we don't know 3. Still, everything around us is pretty good. Are we already trading with everyone?
Before the heir of Lund?
Hey! Sweet. You want to take military access? No. We want to X you out. We're going to go Karakarn. We already have
your ancestors.
They won't join the Confederation. Sounds good. Border princes. Look it this way.
I am ready to parley. I hope you're worthy.
You don't really have anything for me.
Deliver your message.
You don't have anything for me. There's really not a lot for us to trade with. We could piece
these
guys
out. You come for favors, but all I hear is scorn. Always the...
But I don't think I'm going to piece them out, only because I kind of want them to, like, piece me out for money. Let's see if we can trade with you.
Approach and make your offer.
Non-aggression? No. All right, well, that's about all the diplomacy we can do for now. Okay, so the mountains are ours. Are we ready to go in hard here?
Attack!
They are extremely weak. Once again, it's 2 turns. See ya, babe. I think we're just gonna wait for 2 turns. There's really no rush to it right now. Unless, of course, what are they doing? I don't know what he's doing. Now, here's the thing. If they both came and attacked me, we might have a little more issue.
The Slayer in me seeks death.
The Slayer in me seeks death. I like that.
I'm not gonna let's get you back standing home. Here.
Get you full up. I mean, we do have like... Nah, we're fine. We're fine. I'm not gonna rush it. Not gonna rush it. We don't have a grudge or anything like that either that we have to worry about. So there's no reason for me to try rushing it. We are one turn away from finishing the Slayer Shrine, which is gonna be good. Do we want to upgrade? We still need to get you to level 5. We have 3 surplus. Yeah, growth might not be bad. 2,000? Are we going to spend all our money for that? No, because we wanted to upgrade you to rank 2. Yeah. Alright, next turn. We're trying to move a little bit quicker. Trying. Okay, so they are slowly starting to move towards me. Are they dead now? These one-eyed guys should be dead. Red eye. They have 0 provinces. So I'm assuming it's because they still have an army that they're quote-unquote not destroyed. And they have 1 great shaman who is almost dead. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty safe. HP is coming back. That's nice. I suppose let's go in.
Thag them! Destroy them!
Then again, if we wait a turn, we're not going to have to deal with their walls or their towers. And even if he comes at me, he has no one right now. So yes. We're feeling pretty good. Oh, crap. I still have my dude down here. What if we assassinate 24%?
Ready.
26%. Yeah, let's just run you home. I can't believe I just left him there. I actually should probably be looking at taking this guy out. 41%. Yeah, that's not bad. Okay, so we ended our turn, and we have 5,000 more gold. Population surplus is at a 3. We were doing the melee. I want the arsenal here. That leaves me with 1,000 gold. I don't think there was much else we could do for 1,000. So, next turn then. Alaric the Orc Bane. This guy up here just randomly leveled. Okay. We were going for purebred to get rid of vampire corruption. And somehow it's still going up, which is a little stupid, but that's fine. It's low enough that I'm not really concerned. You're kind of neutral at 5%. You kind of neutraled out at 15. See, that's fine. As long as we're not like 30%, 50%, that's when it starts getting bad. We can actually build something here. Eh. What'd you want me to build? More growth? Yeah, sure. Let's go for it. Okay. And now we're going to have ourselves a battle.
The old alliance is dead, so don't come here asking favors.
You want to give me some money? Yeah. That is exactly what I wanted to see. Pay me money for a peace treaty. Thank you very much. We're unworthy. Did it really say that was our diplomacy? So, battle deployment. They're going to get effed. Normally, I would probably just sim this, but I kind of want to see my new weapons in action. From my allies. So, yeah. Hopefully they're coming in from the proper side. There's a couple times where it's, like, really weird and, like, your allies come in from their side and it's just like, oh, God. Alright, put a giant hill right in between me and them. Where are our allies coming in? They're coming in from back there. So let's go ahead and move. We just have regular gyrocopters. Let's go ahead and put you guys here. Put you on 4. Our quarrelers. These are really good quarrelers up here on 3. You guys can take the 2. And I don't have anything like miners nor slayers. All we have is, what, 1 longbeard? So, yeah. And then you're going to be 1. And then you guys are on 5. I love the gyrocopters. I really do. You know what? Actually, we should probably do it like that. So when they drop bombs, they're a little better. What's their range, by the way? 75 compared to the Quarrelers, which is what, 160? Yeah. So their range is pretty terrible, but that's fine. Okay, so you are now one and one. No. Oh, yeah. Pause. P. Let's look at the flamethrowers in all their glory. Oh my gosh. Look, they have like little freaking wolf dragon cannons. Oh, that's so awesome. Okay. Ooh. Those are nice too. I'm okay with that. Well, how's my cannon look? Eh, it looks like a normal cannon. Okay. So, we want to go ahead and go four, and we want to put, nope, four, and we want to put you and you as part of our four. Let's do something like that. What's the range in all these? I think 440, 290, 440. So, the grudge throwers pretty much have the best range we can get. If they're not charging at me, I'm actually totally okay with that. We also have the longbeards with great weapons, dwarf warriors. Yeah, that's all fine. I'm okay with that because I'd like to get my army back into position. Do something like that for now. And then you guys are just going to be like here. Then we probably want one and one. Put you guys like right here. All right. Everyone's going to make some moves. That's fine. They are currently moving at me, so it's going to be a bad day for them. Eh. Put you on six. I want my flamethrowers. You know what? Where's everyone going? Can the flamethrowers hurt my own? Probably. So let's do something like that. They're armored anti-infantry. They actually have really good armor too, 120. Let's go ahead and halt. Let's just go ahead and get these guys shooting. Split them in two. Take a shot. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Who's it gonna hit? Oh, yeah. That one. Oh, it just, like, knocked him the heck out, dude. Oh, God. Those are freaking... Those things, like, hit, man. Oh. I'm digging these. Oh, God. Those look painful. I don't care. They're not as cool as the humans with, like, the whing, because, like, the humans make noise and stuff like that, and they're just freaking awesome. Still, they're not bad. All right, I need you guys to, like, come kill these dudes. Because I actually want to see that happen. We're trying to take him out their air. Unfortunately, I think we're gonna break them before they ever get to us. Yeah, there they go. I want you guys to come like right here, please. That was nice. Well, it looks like we're not gonna get to use the flamethrowers. Well, you know, we're taking over the town. I guess this is worth it because it's for the XP, so. And you guys can just, I don't know where you guys are going. This was pretty much straight up domination, but you know, when they only had like six guys, it was gonna happen. Boom. Alright, I don't think Master Tactician, we've got an achievement for that. We didn't lose any dudes. We deployed about 1,200, they deployed 69, and they lost 69. And it doesn't look like we leveled up at all, but that's fine. It was more like, hey, I wanted to see my new weapons. Okay, so we want to occupy you, please.
Yes. Welcome, friends of the Dowie.
Dowie. They want to join the war. See, I'm already untrustworthy, so I can't actually help you. Sorry. That's going to piss you off a little bit, but I'm already untrustworthy. Okay, he tried attacking me. Province secured. Yep. And Red Eye has been completely obliterated. So,
what?
First up, let's come assassinate this dude. 41%. Goodbye. So that's the top knots, which is these guys over there. Is that their only province? Top knots. I'm sure they're orcs, greenskin. No, they're not greenskin. They're savage orcs. They have 6 settlements. Okay, then. So then the question is, what now? We've pretty much decimated our enemies on all sides. I suppose we could start coming for the mines. Let's see, so we got Irkund, Bitterstone Mine, Dragonholm, and Stonemire Tower. I guess? Yeah, I mean, I don't see why not. Let's go ahead and get some happiness going here. Take the drinking hall just to bump up our happiness a little bit. We can do a province thing, so we're gonna also take happiness. And the reduction, I guess.
Grumbrindle.
Do we want to start moving down here? I don't see why not. Well, okay, here's the thing. I doubt I can actually... Well, maybe. Is there a way to actually tell if I can take it over? It's a green skin thing? So I should be able to take it over. I'm also imagining they really want to piece me out at this point.
I don't want to talk to you, stunty kids.
I imagine he very much would like to piece me out. Because we have decimated the crap out of them. You good, sir? Let's put you on, like, regular.
My oath is intact.
So you can move back and forth if needed. Carrig. Yeah, we'll take a level 2.
I'm here.
So maybe we should go ahead and give you some of the better stuff. Like, do we really need 3 gyrocopters? Probably not. We could swap that. These are just regular longbeards versus the warriors. It's like swap 1 and 1. And then we have longbeard great weapons versus hammerers. So yeah, let's swap you out. I do like both of these. What would I drop? With the cannon or the organ gun? The organ gun was shorter range. .203, .290. Here's the thing. These grudge throwers aren't gonna be as good. They have 440, 148. 440, 148. So the range was 440, which is the same. 148. So these are significantly more damage. So the truth is we should probably actually swap these out and take out like one of them. And we'll leave a grudge thrower as well. That's going to give us 1, 2, 3. I think that's fine.
Retake the
and we're
rails.
At 19 and 20. Ah, I got chips stuck in my throat. One sec. Take a sip of my beer because I got chips stuck in my throat. Okay, so I guess then we're going to go ahead and start moving south with you. Let's see if we can get out of the attrition, which we can. We're going to take attrition for moving through this. Are we going to actually take damage moving through here?
Throw banners!
No.
Let's march.
Okay. Yo, so we're fine there. And then you...
It is time.
I suppose we're just going to put here just to keep this up a little bit, like keep making them a little happier. Then we really need to get you coming down and joining this army. But it's going to take a little bit of time before we get there, and I guess we're just going to continue our conquest south.
I grow restless.
I suppose we could also move over here towards the Black Iron Mine. They do have a pretty decent force over there.
Ready.
The question is, where the heck are the rest of the greenskin settlements? I mean, we got three or four over here. How many total ones did they have left? 11. My gosh. Oof. All right, then. Now, they have a decent-sized army here. Wow, a lot of rock lobbers. Well, here's the question, then. Bitterstone Mine. They do have a decent-sized army, man.
I'm ready.
Screw it. Let's keep our army together. Just so we can take them out. And we're not, like, no one has declared war on us, so we're pretty freaking safe back here. I need to use you to actually assassinate a character. Let's not forget that.
One rag. Forwards!
33%, but I don't have enough funds. So we're just gonna go put you over here. And next turn, so Orcbane, we maxed you out. Yeah, you're up to level 10. So we can do the grudge, which gives us more. Nah, I think we're gonna come down here. Because we're going for the warding.
I'm here.
And then the white dwarf. Oh. Oh, this is my new guy, the white dwarf. So we gave him plus 20%. Unit experience, plus one for all unit recruits faction-wide. We can reduce the land units faction-wide. Movement range, casualty replenishment, or global recruitment capacity. I think I'm going to do unit experience to begin with. That's actually really good. Faction freaking wide, man. That's nice. And he's coming out at me. I love how it looks like there were dragons flying around there. And you're going somewhere. So they finished? Wow, so he got critically failed trying to block me. Brutal business. Battle is a blood-soaked affair. Limbs severed, bones exposed, men left for dead, and cur-soaked fields amongst scores of fallen friends and enemies. Strong weapons forged with time. Sweat and expertise mark the difference between victory and defeat. A good sword cuts through bones, severing heads and limbs, whereas lesser weapons will merely maim. As instability grows across the world, so does a man's bloodlust and desire for war and carnage in the ever grander scale. So we get weapon damage plus 20 for all armies of all factions. Interesting. So everyone does more damage right now. That's a little on the crazy side. Alright, well, I think we're going to wrap this episode up here. We're expanding our dwarf kingdom quite efficiently. I feel pretty secure. Right now we're only at war with the greenskins. And they're pretty, I mean, they're pretty crappy right now. They actually have a 12th strength, so they've actually been building up their forces a little bit. Still, I feel pretty safe in our attacking. We're going to start moving in on this province here. Hopefully, we can grab that one. That's going to be our next goal. From there, not entirely sure. We should probably maybe move this direction and clear this out. We got the 8 peaks. Valhero's Sorrow. So there's two more down here then. This one, they must just be like over here. I still don't know. We got the Black Crag. I mean, this is kind of our defensive army that's kind of able to hop back and forth between either one. I wonder if we should maybe be looking at recruiting. We can do some miners. Also, wouldn't mind a cannon. I think we're going to take a cannon just for the heck of it. All right, but anyways, if you guys enjoyed this series, go ahead, drop a like. Go ahead and comment. Let me know what you guys think. And as always, hit the subscribe button. Join the game comment. Share your support. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.